Very good morning to one and all. In our previous class, we have discussed what is known to be the natural rubber. What is known to be natural rubber? Natural rubber, when I am discussing, natural rubber is a combination of the monomeric units. Natural rubber which contain in the monomer, and the monomer, what we are saying is isoprene. Okay? Natural rubber lo monomer entante isoprene. Isoprene ante em cheptunna? Isoprene is nothing but 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Right? Isoprene is nothing but 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene is known to be that isoprene. 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene is known to be isoprene. And this isoprene gives rise to polyisoprene. Right? Ethylene to polyethylene. Styrene to polystyrene. Vinyl chloride to polyvinyl chloride. In a similar fashion, just I would like to take isoprene to polyisoprene. Isoprene to polyisoprene. Polyisoprene is known to be natural rubber. Now, in a previous class, we have discussed how the rubber is extracted. Rubber can be extracted from rubber tree. Rubber tree containing rubber milk. Rubber milk was known to be the latex. Latex containing 60% impurities. Latex containing only 30 to 40% of the rubber. Now the latex is washed with the water. Then the impure latex is converted to be the pure latex. To the pure latex, we are adding coagulant. Coagulation process, what we are saying is precipitation. The liquid latex is converted to give solid. The solid latex which is collected, and now it is passed through the hot air or smoke houses. The process should be heated for 4 days. We should maintain the temperature about 40 to 50 degrees centigrade, or we should maintain the temperature about 60 degrees centigrade. When the solid rubber is heated for 60 degrees centigrade or 40 to 50 degrees centigrade, about 4 to 5 days, the solid rubber, initially which containing gelatin like structure, initially it seems to be gel like geometry. Now the gel like rubber is converted to give a complete solid like rubber, and it can be molded into two types of shapes. The first category of shape I'm saying as a crepe rubber. The second category of shape I'm saying as a smoke rubber. Now let me explain the drawbacks of natural rubber. When we are discussing about the drawbacks of natural rubber, the rubber which containing a soft and sticky nature when you're applying the higher temperature. The point to pinch konana. Now, the rubber which containing less thermal resistance. I'm repeating. The word less thermal resistance indicating that when we are increasing temperature, rubber becomes soft and the rubber becomes sticky nature. When we are decreasing the temperature, the rubber becomes hard and as well as a brittle. Rubber, when you're discussing which containing less acid resistant, less water resistant, and less oil resistant. In Malu Chapter. When you are discussing about rubber, rubber containing less temperature resistant, less water resistant, less oil resistant, less chemical resistant. Then, now this is known to be rubber. Rubber is known to be elastomer. Rubber is known to be that elastomer. The rubber which is known to be elastomer, and this rubber containing the following drawbacks. Next. Now let me see what is known to be a compounding process. Compounding is a method where a low property rubber is converted to give high property of rubber. Properties of increased steadily can add to a reagent ne compounding reagents under last time manu nechukunnam kada then plastic lo nechukunnam the low property of plastic is converted to give high property of plastic. In a similar fashion, just I would like to add some of the additive to the rubber. When we are adding some of the additive to the rubber, then what will happen? The low property of rubber is converted to give high property of rubber. Now simple. Then what are the additives that is added to the rubber? We can see in the step by step. The first one is known to be filler. Number 2 is known to be vulcanizing agent. Number 3 is known to be the catalyst. Number 4 is known to be coloring agent. Number 5 is known to be antioxidant. Number 6 is known to be the plasticizer. Then what is known to be filler? Now just I would like to take the rubber. To the rubber I'm adding zinc oxide and as well as carbon black. Then what will happen? When these additives like zinc oxide and the carbon black, when it is added to the filler, then the rubber physical property increases. The rubber become hardness, right? The less mechanical strength of the rubber can be converted to give the high mechanical strength composites. Next one. Then what is known to be a vulcanizing agent? The addition of sulfur to the rubber at 140 degrees centigrade temperature. Especially I'm adding sulfur to the rubber. The process what I'm saying is vulcanization. Vulcanization is a process where the low property of rubber is converted to give high property of rubber. Next one. let me tell you what is known to be that coloring agent. The coloring agents are added to the rubber to get a specific color. The elastomer chipper rubber is known to be colorless now. Initially, we prepare just the colorless. Now, I would like to get a white color. Just I would like to add a little like titanium oxide, ferric oxide add cheyali, red color, chromium oxide add cheyali, green color, carbon black add cheyali, black color. When these additives are added to the rubber, then what will happen? Then the rubber having the low color property, the rubber having the colorless character gives rise to definite colors. Definite colors are identified for the rubber material. I'm repeating. Definite colors are identified for the rubber material by the addition of coloring agent. Next one. Then what is known to be the antioxidants, right? When the antioxidants are added to the rubber, antioxidants like organic amines, phenolic compounds, and phosphate substances. Organic amines, phenolic substances, phosphatic substances add chain. When these organic elements are added to the rubber, oxidation resistance of rubber increases. Simple. Rubber initially containing a less oxidation resistant character. Oxidation resistant ante chuddam. When we are placing the rubber in the environment which containing oxygen, then rubber will be disintegrated. Now, to the rubber, when I'm adding phenolic compound, when you're adding organic amine, when you're adding the phosphate, then what will happen? An ordinary rubber is converted to give the improved property, compounding of rubber. And that compounding of rubber which containing excellent oxidation resistance. The oxidation resistant is nothing but antioxidant nature. The antioxidant nature of rubber, which is increased by the addition of organic amines, phenolic compound, and as well as phosphate substances. Next one. What is known to be the plastigers? The plastiger which is added to the rubber to increase in the flexibility to the rubber. The point is last time what I mentioned chepthanu. Plastigers eppudaithe nenu malli cheptunnanu. Plastigers meer eppudaithe rubber compounds gaani plastics gaani add chestunaro. Plastiger increasing the molding capability. Plastiger which increasing that flexibility. The more is the flexibility, the more is the molding character. Ante mana teeskuna plastics gaani rubbers gaani mana mold cheyadaniki molding property increase cheyadaniki meer em chestunnarana plastigers add chestaru. So and all these additives are added to the natural rubber. The first one I'm saying is a filler. Filler increasing the mechanical strength. Number two is known to be vulcanizing rubber. The vulcanization is a process where the rubber mechanical property increases very high. So a soft rubber is converted to give hard rubber. Vulcanized rubber is known to be that ignite rubber. Vulcanized rubber is also known to be that industrial rubber. Okay. The next condition I'm saying is accelerator. They are known to be the catalyst. The catalyst increases rate of reaction, increase the process of rubber formation. Next one. The fourth condition I'm saying is a coloring agent. Rubber material containing the different color formation. The different color formation is identified to the rubber material by the addition of coloring agents. The next one I'm saying is antioxidant. Antioxidants like organic amine, phenolic compound, and phosphate substances, which is added to the rubber. When they are added to the rubber, oxidation resistant value increases. The next last condition I'm saying is a plastigers. Plastigers are known to be that vegetable oil, waxes, and as well as resins. When they were added to the rubber material, then they can soften the rubber, they can increase the flexibility. The flexibility is nothing but plasticity. Plasticity and flexibility are not obtained. The more is the flexibility, the more is the molding property. And all these additives, when we are adding to the rubber, when we are adding all the additives to the rubber, then what will happen? The low property of rubber is converted to give high property of rubber. The process what we are saying is compounding. Initially, the same plastic nechukunnamandi. Compounding of plastic. When the additives are added to the plastic, the low property of plastic is converted to give high property of plastic. Same procedure rubber applied chain. When those additives are added, when these additives are added to the rubber, then what will happen? The low property of rubber is converted to give high property of rubber. Okay. Next. Manaku oka 10 minutes time undi, em problem ledandi, ilo chuddam. Syllabus manaku in time lane complete avutundi. The next content is a very, very important, right? That is known to be that vulcanization. Okay. Let me tell you what is known to be the vulcanization of rubber. When I'm discussing about the vulcanization process, in the vulcanization process, to the natural rubber, just I'm adding sulfur at 140 to 120 degrees centigrade temperature, 120 to 140 degrees centigrade temperature, in the presence of carbon dioxide atmospheric pressure condition. Simple. And 30 to 35% of rubber is added to that natural rubber. The resultant rubber, what we are saying is ignite. Simple, na natural rubber ki, meru అబౌట్ 35 to 40% మీరు ఏం చేస్తున్నారండి, సల్ఫర్ని యాడ్ చేస్తున్నారు. మీరు సల్ఫర్ని యాడ్ చేసేటప్పుడు కండిషన్స్ గుర్తుంచుకోండి, కార్బన్ డైఆక్సైడ్ అట్మాస్ఫిరిక్ కండిషన్ యాడ్ చేయండి ఇన్ ద ప్రెన్స్ ఆఫ్ హైడ్రోజన్ సల్ఫైడ్ S2SCl2. ఓకే, సల్ఫర్ డైక్లోరైడ్ కండిషన్ యాడ్ చేయండి, దెన్ వాట్ విల్ హ్యాపెన్? అండ్ ఆర్డినరీ రబ్బర్ ఇస్ కన్వర్టెడ్ టు ఇబ్నైట్ రబ్బర్. ఆర్డినరీ రబ్బర్ ని ఇబ్నైట్ రబ్బర్ కింద కన్వర్ట్ చేయడానికి మీరు ఏం చేస్తున్నారన్న, సల్ఫర్ యాడ్ చేస్తున్నారు. నౌ విల్ సీ ద ప్రాసెస్. నౌ సీ దిస్, యూ కెన్ సీ ద కెమికల్ రియాక్షన్. ఓకే, నౌ ఇట్ ఈస్ నోన్ టు బి నేచురల్ రబ్బర్ అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నోన్ టు బి ద నేచురల్ రబ్బర్. నేచురల్ రబ్బర్ అని చెప్పు నేను, నేచురల్ రబ్బర్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ పాలిసిస్ ఐసోప్రీన్. ఐమ్ రిపీటింగ్, పాలిసిస్ ఐసోప్రీన్. ఓకే, నౌ విచ్ కంటైనింగ్ ఐసోప్రీన్ యూనిట్స్, ఐసోప్రీన్ మోనోమర్ అండ్ పాలీ ఐసోప్రీన్ ఇస్ నోన్ టు బి రబ్బర్. నౌ దిస్ ఈస్ ఐసోప్రీన్, 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 నేచురల్ రబ్బర్, నేచురల్ రబ్బర్, నేచురల్ రబ్బర్ అండ్ ఫాలోడ్ బై నేచురల్ రబ్బర్. నౌ టు ద నేచురల్ రబ్బర్ కాంపోజైట్స్ జస్ట్ ఐమ్ యాడింగ్ సల్ఫర్. సీ దిస్, కొంచెం జాగ్రత్తగా ఉందా. టు ద నేచురల్ రబ్బర్ కాంపోజైట్ జస్ట్ ఐమ్ యాడింగ్ సల్ఫర్ అండ్ హియర్ ఇన్ బిట్వీన్ వీఆర్ యాడింగ్ సల్ఫర్ అండ్ హియర్ ఇన్ బిట్వీన్ వీఆర్ కెన్ యాడింగ్ సల్ఫర్. జస్ట్ యూ కెన్ గివ్ ద నేమ్ హియర్, ఐసోప్రీన్ కంటైనింగ్, పాలీ ఐసోప్రీన్ కంటైనింగ్ 1, 2, 3, 4 కార్బన్ సిస్టమ్ విచ్ కంటైనింగ్ 1, 2, 3, 4 కార్బన్ సిస్టమ్ అండ్ ఇట్ కంటైనింగ్ 1, 2, 3, 4 కార్బన్ సిస్టమ్ అండ్ యూఆర్ టేకింగ్ 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4 కార్బన్ సిస్టమ్. చెప్పండి 1, 2, 3, 4 కార్బన్ సిస్టమ్. దెన్ వాట్ విల్ హ్యాపన్ హియర్, రైట్? నౌ హియర్ ఐమ్ యాడింగ్ సల్ఫర్, దిస్ ఈస్ నోన్ టు బి సల్ఫర్. ఓకే, అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆల్సో నోన్ టు బి ద సల్ఫర్. When the sulfur is added to the rubber, then what will happen? When the sulfur is added in between second carbon, this is second carbon, and this is second carbon, right? And it is also known to be that a second carbon, third carbon, and it is known to be that third carbon. And in between, there is a possibility of sulfur addition. In between, the sulfur addition takes place, right? Then, in between, sulfur addition takes place. In between, sulfur addition takes place. In between. Sulfur addition takes place, right? Then which carbon it is? 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? The sulfur is added at second carbon. 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 Then what is the difference between a natural rubber compared with the vulcanized rubber? Now it is known to be the vulcanized rubber. Jatka chuddhanan, aimless. The natural rubber, when we are taking, the geometry is two dimensional. నేచురల్ రబ్బర్ జామెట్రీ ఏంటన్నా, నేచురల్ రబ్బర్ జామెట్రీ ఈస్ నోన్ టు బి ద టూ డైమెన్షన్ అండి. జాగ్రత్తగా నౌ టు ద నేచురల్ రబ్బర్ జస్ట్ వాట్ యూఆర్ యాడింగ్ హియర్, సల్ఫర్. నౌ యూఆర్ మెయింటైనింగ్ ద టెంపరేచర్ 140 degrees centigrade టెంపరేచర్. దెన్ వాట్ విల్ హ్యాపన్? సల్ఫర్ ఈస్ యాడెడ్ హియర్, సల్ఫర్ ఈస్ యాడెడ్ హియర్. సో సల్ఫర్ ఈస్ యాడెడ్ ఎట్ C2 carbon ఫాలోడ్ బై C3 carbon. సల్ఫర్ ఈస్ యాడెడ్ ఎట్ C2 carbon ఫాలోడ్ బై C3 carbon. దెన్ టు ద నేచురల్ రబ్బర్ వెన్ యూఆర్ యాడింగ్ సల్ఫర్, దెన్ వాట్ విల్ హ్యాపన్? సింపుల్. To the natural rubber, when we are adding the sulfur, a two-dimensional geometry is converted to give a three-dimensional geometry. Simple. 2D geometry is converted to give three-dimensional geometry. Rubber is always containing amorphous nature. Point kuthinch ponana. Rubber is always containing amorphous nature. Then, when we are taking about vulcanized rubber is always containing crystalline. What is the difference between amorphous and the crystalline? Right? The word amorphous indicating that irregular, the word crystalline indicating that regular. So natural rubber is known to be amorphous geometry, vulcanized rubber is known to be the crystalline geometry. Natural rubber is known to be two dimensional and the vulcanized rubber is known to be the three dimensional. Natural rubber is containing a two dimensional branched chain polymer. Point gurtunchukodana, natural rubber, I'm saying two dimensional branched chain polymer. When we are saying about that vulcanized rubber is the best example for three-dimensional crystalline polymer. I'm repeating, three-dimensional crystalline polymer. Now when we are saying the compounding process, when you are adding the sulfur at 120 to 140 degrees centigrade to the natural rubber, then what will happen? Natural rubber is converted to give vulcanized rubber. Vulcanized rubber is three-dimensional. Vulcanized rubber containing crystalline. Vulcanized containing cross chain linkage. Vulcanized rubber containing cross chain linkage. The more is a crystalline, the more is a regular geometry. So when the amorphous polymer is converted to give the crystalline, then what will happen? Its physical properties increases, its mechanical properties increases, water resistant increases, then oil resistant increases, the chemical resistant increases, thermal resistance increases. So The low property of rubber, which is increased by the addition of sulfur at 120 to 140 degrees centigrade, the process what I'm saying as a vulcanization. Simple and the process is known to be that vulcanization. By the vulcanization method, then the rubber has a good tensile strength. The rubber physical strength is increases. The rubber load bearing cable can tell that na just vulcanized rubber sheet this condi. Then with the continuous load applied chandi. Rubber sheet is called load apply cheyandi. The rubber sheet containing deformation character, breaking character, and the vulcanizer sheet containing the high load bearing capability. That indicating that which is containing high physical strength, excellent tensile strength, excellent mechanical strength. Tensile strength and mechanical strength identify cheyandi calculate chestarandi. Then the vulcanizer rubber containing the tensile strength that is equals to 1 to 1000. Idi meeku ikkada mention cheyadu, mention chestunanu 1 to 1000 kg per cm square, right? It is known to be that the high tensile strength, high mechanical strength. Next one, which containing excellent load bearing capability. Now, which is having excellent electrical insulation property. There is only one reason: vulcanized rubber or the tires they are used in the insulation materials. Now, which containing excellent water resistant property, which is having the high corrosion resistant property and as well as the high chemical resistant property. Kuri property of some such just now andi, it is low elasticity and high. Ikkada low match konna na. It is low here and it is high here. Simple, low elastic character and high water low elasticity and low water absorption character. Low water absorption indicating that now which containing excellent water resistant property. And all these properties when we are discussing about vulcanization of rubber, vulcanization is a process of compounding. Simple ga chuddam, vulcanization is a process of compounding. Vulcanization is a method where a two dimensional rubber is converted to give three dimensional. An amorphous rubber is converted to give a crystalline. Less physical strength of the rubber is converted to give the more physical strength of the rubber. Now, and where we are using that ibnite rubber. The rubber name is ibnite rubber, sulfur containing rubber. Sulfur containing rubber is used in automobiles and automobile tires. Right now, my tires choose na randi. Tires oxide is bunchy and which containing a bad smell. The word bad smell indicating that tire containing about 35 to 40% of rubber. Right now. Vulcanized rubber or the sulfur containing rubber, which is used in the industry, then they are known to be that industrial rubbers or ibnite rubbers. Okay, now they are having the wide application. They might be used in the sulfur containing sheets, then the ibnite sheets that might be used in the domestic application and as well as industrial application. Let me explain again. Just I would like to discuss about the vulcanization process. In the vulcanization process, where I'm taking that natural rubber, to the natural rubber we are adding the compounding agents, right? The compoundings like fillers, number 2 vulcanizing agents, number 3 is a catalyst, number 4 is known to be coloring agent, number 5 is known to be antioxidant, number 6 is known to be the plasticizer. When those additives are added to the rubber, then what will happen? Low property of rubber can be converted to give high property of rubber. In those condition, just you are discussing the second part is important and examination of continuous adutunnadu, that is known to be that. Tell me what is known to be that vulcanization application followed by the advantages. Vulcanization is a process where a low property of rubber is converted to give high property of rubber by the addition of sulfur at 140 degrees centigrade. And this process where the rubber physical strength is increases to 1 to 1000 kg per centimeter square. The tensile strength is increases to the maximum. Okay. Now it's all about. Now, just we are discussing about it's all about the rubber process.